Okay, two-step inequalities. What we're going to be doing in this lesson is graphing these inequality equations and graphing them on this number line here. Okay, we're going to be solving for x and then graphing it on this number line here. Okay, to get started, first things we need to know is that there's two types of inequalities. We have the strict inequalities and we have the non-strict inequalities. Okay, for the strict inequalities, it's going to get very, very close to the number, but it's not going to include the number itself. In other words, if we have something like x is greater than 3, okay, then we look on our number line, we have 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, it's going to be greater than, x is going to be greater than 3. So what we're going to do is put an open circle, okay, and it's going to be everything to the right. This is the greater than, all the way up to positive infinity. Okay, now the strict inequality is not going to include the number 3. It's going to get very close. What I mean by that is that it's going to be something like 3.000000 on and on forever with a 1 tacked on the very end. Okay, it's going to get infinitely close to the number 3, but it's not going to include the number 3 itself. Now, that differs from a non-strict inequality, in that the non-strict inequality is going to include the number as well. So let's say we have something like x is greater than or equal to 4. And then we go to our number line, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, for a non-strict inequality, it's going to be a closed circle. We're going to fill that circle in with we're going to color it in. And in this case, greater than is everything to the right, all the way to positive infinity. Okay, and it's also going to include the number 4. Okay, it's going to include the number 4. We can include the number 4 with a non-strict inequality. So that's the main difference. Non-strict inequality includes the number. Strict inequality does not include the number, but it gets infinitely close. Okay, the strict inequality gets infinitely close. Okay, one more thing to note when we're doing inequalities, that let's say we're trying to solve for the variable x, so I need to divide both sides by negative 3, okay, to get x by itself. Whenever you're going to multiply or divide, okay, across an inequality by a negative number, so anytime you're multiplying or dividing by a negative number across an inequality, what's going to happen is it's going to change directions. Okay, so now we have this. X is less than 18 over negative 3. So x is less than negative 6. Okay, this is the main idea here, is that whenever you're going to multiply or divide, okay, across an inequality, so to get x by itself, we have to divide both sides by negative 3. Okay, whenever we multiply or divide by a negative number across an inequality, it's going to change direction. Okay, see, it went from this direction, now it's pointing the other way. So that's what you need to do anytime you're multiplying or dividing by a negative number across an inequality, it's going to change direction. All right, let's do our first problem here. We have 2x plus 4 is greater than or equal to 24. Okay, first thing we're going to do is subtract 4 from both sides. So you're just going to treat these the same way you treat normal equations, like 2x plus 4 equals 24, right? We try to get x by itself. We're going to be doing the same thing. The only difference is, we're working with inequalities. So let's get to work on this one. We're going to subtract 4 from both sides. So that cancels out 4 here, so we have 2x is greater than or equal to 24 minus 4. Okay, that means 2x is greater than or equal to 20. Okay, now what we need to do is divide both sides by 2. Okay, that gets rid of this, gets x by itself. So we have x is greater than or equal to 20 divided by 2. So x is greater than or equal to 10. Okay, this is how we do it. So now we have our inequality. Let's say we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, greater than or equal to. As you recall, it's going to be a closed circle. Okay, we're going to color it in. And a greater than is this direction, all the way to positive infinity. So that's graphing our first one there. X is greater than or equal to 10. Okay, problem number 2. M divided by 3 minus 3 is less than or equal to negative 6. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is add 3 to both sides. So here we're adding 3. Here we're adding 3. Okay, that's going to cancel it out over here. So we have, now we have M over 3 is less than or equal to negative 6 plus 3. Okay, that means M over 3 is less than or equal to negative 6 plus 3 is negative 3. Okay, now to get M by itself, we're going to multiply both sides by 3. Okay, so times 3 over 1 times 3 over 1. Okay, that cancels it out here, so we're left with M is less than or equal to negative 9. Okay, and there's our inequality. M is less than or equal to negative 9. So if we have 0, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, 4, 5, negative 6, negative 7, negative 8, negative 9, less than or equal to means a closed circle. Okay, it's going to include the number 9. It's going to include the number 9. And less than or equal to is going to be everything in this direction, all the way to negative infinity. Okay, there's our M is less than or equal to negative 9. Okay, next problem. Negative 3 times P plus 1 is less than or equal to negative 18. Now, maybe you are going to try to distribute this negative 3 into this, what's inside these parentheses here. But what I recommend doing is instead of distributing it in, just go ahead and divide both sides by negative 3. So divide by negative 3, divide by negative 3. Now you notice that we're dividing across this inequality with a negative number, so the inequality is going to change direction. Okay, so first of all, this is going to cancel out. So what we're left with is P plus 1. Now we need to change the direction of the inequality. So now we're going to say that's greater than or equal to negative 18 divided by negative 3. So P plus 1 is greater than or equal to 6. Okay, now to get the variable P by itself, we're going to subtract 1 from both sides. So subtract 1, that's going to cancel that out here. So we're left with P is greater than or equal to 6 minus 1. It means P is greater than or equal to 5. Okay, so looking at our number line, we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Greater than or equal to is going to include the number 5. So we're going to color it in like so. Okay, we're going to color it in. It's going to be everything to the right here, all the way to positive infinity. Okay, there's our graph for P is greater than or equal to the number 5. Okay, a new problem. Negative 4 times negative 4 plus x is greater than 56. Okay, this is our strict inequality. So to get the variable x by itself, first we're going to have to divide both sides by this negative 4. See, this negative 4 is being multiplied by all this in here. Okay, instead of distributing, I mean, that's usually going to probably be your first instinct is to distribute this in here. But that's not necessary. You're just creating an extra step. So instead of distributing it, we're just going to divide to get rid of it. So we're going to divide both sides by negative 4. Okay, once again, we are dividing over the inequality sign with a negative number. So this inequality sign is going to have to change directions. Okay, but first of all, that's going to cancel out this negative 4 here. So now what we're left with is what's inside the parentheses. Okay, which is negative 4 plus x. Now remember, we have to switch the direction of the sign here. So it was greater than, now it's going to be lesser than. Okay, 56 divided by negative 4. Okay, so what we're left with is negative 4 plus x is less than, and 56 divided by negative 4 is negative 14. So we have negative 4 plus x is less than negative 14. Okay, now to get this variable x by itself, we need to add 4 to both sides. Okay, here it's being subtracted. So to get rid of something being subtracted, we do the opposite, we add. So we're going to add 4 to both sides. Okay, so now we have x is less than negative 14 plus 4, which means x is less than negative 10. Okay, I just want to reiterate one more time that the inequality is going to switch directions when we multiply or divide by a negative number. Okay, that doesn't count for adding or subtracting. Okay, it's only when you're multiplying or dividing across that it switches directions. Okay, not subtraction or addition. Okay, it's only for multiplication or division. So now that we finish here, we have x is less than negative 10. So let's just say 0, 1, 2, 3, these are negative. Negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6, negative 7, negative 8, negative 9, negative 10. Okay, it's less than negative 10. So it's going to get very close, but it's not going to include the number 10. So it goes everything in this direction, all the way to negative infinity. Okay, strict inequalities get an open circle. So that means it's going to get infinitely close to negative 10, but it's not going to actually include the number negative 10. So in other words, it's going to be from negative infinity, okay, all the way to, negative 10.00000000. And these zeros go on and on forever with a little one tacked on the very end. Okay, gets infinitely close to the number negative 10, but it doesn't actually include the number negative 10. All right, negative b minus 2 is greater than 8. Okay, to get this variable b by itself, first thing we're going to do is add 2 to both sides. So plus 2 plus 2, that's going to cancel that out there. So what we're left with is negative b is greater than 8 plus 2. 8 plus 2 is 10. Okay, now to get b by itself, see we have this negative number here. We have to divide both sides by negative 1. Okay, that's going to get rid of this negative sign here. But because we are dividing both sides by a negative number, we have to switch the direction of this inequality. So it was greater than, so now it's going to be lesser than. So we have b is lesser than negative 10. Okay, 10 divided by negative 1 is negative 10. So b is less than negative 10. Okay, so here's our number line. I'm just kind of going by twos here. So here we have negative 10. It's going to be less than negative 10. So we're going to do an open circle. Okay, less than is everything this direction all the way to negative infinity. So b is less than negative 10. All right, here's our next problem. Negative 4 times 3 plus n is greater than negative 32. So once again, instead of distributing, okay, you don't do that. Maybe your instinct is telling you to distribute. You're just giving yourself an extra step. So instead of doing that, we're just going to get rid of it by dividing both sides by negative 4. Okay, once again, that's going to cancel out these negative 4s. What we're left with is 3 plus n. And once again, we're dividing by negative 4 across the inequality sign, so we have to switch the direction of the inequality. So it was greater than, so now it's going to be lesser than, is lesser than. Negative 32 divided by negative 4 equals 8. Okay, now to get n by itself, we're going to subtract 3 from both sides. Okay, that's going to get rid of this. It's going to leave n by itself. So we have n is less than 8 minus 3 is 5. So here we have our inequality. N is less than 5. So if we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here's the number 5, less than 5, we're going to put an open circle. It's going to be everything to the left, okay, all the way to negative infinity. So n is less than 5. It's going to get very close to the number 5, but it's not going to include it. Okay, so it's going to be something like 4.99999, you know, infinite number of nines here. It's going to be infinitely close to the number 5, but it's not going to actually include the number 5. All right, 4 plus n divided by 3 is less than 6. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to subtract 4 from both sides. So subtract 4 here, subtract 4 here. That cancels it out. What we're left with is n over 3 is less than 6 minus 4 is 2. Now to get n by itself, we need to multiply both sides by 3. Okay, so times 3 times 3. Okay, that's essentially canceling this out because, you know, you have your fraction here. 3 is just basically 3 over 1. So it cancels it out. What we're left with is n is less than 6. Okay, so here's our number line. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Less than 6. So it's going to be an open circle. It's going to be everything to the left. Okay, all the way to negative infinity. And it's going to get very, very close to the number 6, but it's not going to include the number 6. Okay, it's going to be something like 5.99999. Infinitely close as possible to the number 6, but it's not going to actually include the number 6. It's going to get very, very close. Infinitely close, as a matter of fact. Infinitely close to the number 6, but not including the number 6. Okay, next problem, negative 1 is less than or equal to v minus 2 divided by 21. Now, what I like to do is I usually like to work with these variables on the left-hand side. Okay, and to do that, we're just going to kind of make the mirror opposite of what we're looking at here. So in other words, we're going to put the v minus 2 over 21 over here on the left side. And remember, that's greater than, so you got to maintain this, that this v minus 2 over 21 is going to be greater than, so greater than or equal to, and then we can put the negative 1. So see, this is just the flip-flop. We just kind of flip-flopped it around, but you need to maintain this, okay? See, the open alligator mouth, that's kind of how they taught us, open alligator mouth is facing the v minus 2 over 21, so we got to make sure that stays consistent. Okay, we could switch them back and forth like this, but the inequality has to stay consistent. So this open alligator mouth still has to face this v minus 2 over 21. Okay, so kind of putting it like this makes it just consistent, just because I like to work with the variables on the left-hand side. So to get the variable v by itself, first thing we're going to have to do is multiply both sides by 21 to get rid of this 21 in the denominator. So we're going to multiply this side by 21, and we're going to multiply this side by 21. So what that does is that cancels these out. What we're left with is v minus 2 is greater than or equal to negative 1 times 21 is negative 21. Okay, now to get v by itself, we're going to add 2 to both sides. So plus 2 here, plus 2 here. What we're left with is v is greater than or equal to negative 21 plus 2 is negative 19. So what we have is v is greater than or equal to negative 19. Okay, so here's our number line. And negative 19 is right here. Okay, and this is a non-strict inequality, so that means we're going to color it in. It's going to include the number negative 19, and it's greater than. So from negative 19 all the way to positive infinity. Okay, right here is the number negative 19. Okay, last problem that we're going to be doing today. We have x divided by negative 6 minus 8 is less than or equal to negative 12. Okay, so we're going to try and work at this variable x by itself. To do that, first thing we're going to do is add 8 to both sides. Okay, that cancels it out here. What we're left with is x divided by negative 6 is less than or equal to negative 12 plus 8 is negative 4. Okay, now to get this variable x by itself, we need to multiply both sides by negative 6. And when we do that, it's going to change the direction of this inequality sign. So we're going to multiply by negative 6, multiply by negative 6. Okay, that cancels it out here. What we're left with is x. Now remember, once again, we're multiplying both sides by negative numbers, so this inequality sign needs to change directions. So before, x was lesser than or equal to, now it needs to be greater than or equal to. And negative 4 times negative 6 is a positive 24. So we have our inequality here. X is greater than or equal to 24. Okay, so here we have our number line. Here's the number 24. Okay, greater than or equal to means that we're going to fill that dot in, so it's going to include the number 24, and that's going to be greater than or equal to, so everything all the way to positive infinity. Okay, you've made it to the end of this video. Just a quick reminder that when multiplying or dividing by a negative number across the inequality, it's going to change the direction. Okay, that's the main thing to remember about inequalities. If you like this type of video, please press the like button, leave a comment down below, and if you want to see more, subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thanks for watching.